Hi everybody, it's Tuesday. I'm sorry for not vlogging on Saturday and Sunday. So this is what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try to vlog today and just kind of make up for that and make up for these days that I haven't been vlogging, so forgive me. I'm having a drink and a cigarette because I need it. I just gotta work. I'm tired. Okay, so let's start off with Saturday. Saturday was my kid's godmother's, her son's 5th birthday party. So I didn't know what to get a boy for a gift, so I ended up getting him a giant plastic grill so he could pretend he's barbecuing. It was either that or a plastic little kitchen. My daughter really wanted the little kitchen for him because she wanted to play right along with him. But I felt like the kitchen was kind of feminine, you know? Like, I don't know. You know how it is with boys. It's a little bit different. So, the grill was the next best thing. He likes it, I suppose. Okay. So, it's the birthday party. And I already have the gift all wrapped up. My boyfriend is supposed to come and be with me. To the party. He kept reassuring me that he was gonna come. I didn't believe him, and then he came. So he came with his stepson, and so it was me, him, my daughter, and his stepson. To the party we went. This was our first official social outing, I suppose, and it was nice. It's been a while. Our first official holiday was the 4th of July. We saw some fireworks. I got to spend time with him. We just made 6 months yesterday. Wow, 6 months already we've been. Things are going great. I was really happy having him there. It was a little bit different for both of us, I guess. You know, you never know what to do at a party, especially if you don't know anybody. But I think it was good. I think it was a good day. It was comfortable. The party theme was carnival. So there was a cotton candy machine, popcorn machine, there was cake, cupcakes, candy apples, potato chips, food, 2 bounce houses, a regular bounce house, and one that had a water slide. And so, my goodness, my daughter was bouncing in the bounce house. She got hurt. She didn't want to go back in there. She did not want to go on the water bounce house for a little bit because there were a lot of big kids, and like there was these 2 really, really big overweight kids. And so, my goodness, they kept going down the slide and like running over people that were down in the little waiting pool or whatever. So I don't blame my kid for not wanting to get in there. It was like those kids were like 2 giant bowling balls, and all the other kids in the little waiting pool were like freaking bowling ball pins, you know, and they were just like, brrr, strike. So yeah, but after the big kids left, my daughter got in. And so did my boyfriend's stepson, and they had a nice time. The 2 big giant bowling ball kids were still there, but you know, what can you do? After a while, they started hitting each other, and it was like 2 bowling balls clashing and shit. It was good. There was a lot of food. My friend made homemade mac and cheese, barbecue chicken, and what else? I think that was it for the food portion. Oh, hot dogs and hamburgers, of course. So, my daughter had a big plate of mac and cheese and chicken. My boyfriend ate normal, of course, because he's normal. And I got a couple bites of mac and cheese and a little bit of chicken off of her plate. My sweet, and my kid ate a little bit, you know, because she wanted to like get in the regular bounce house. My poor boyfriend, he got so stuffed that day. He ate he ate his food, and then the rest of the food that was left over from our plate. I had 1 whole hot dog, plus the mac and cheese and a little bit of chicken. I had lots of cotton candy because it was really delicious. And I took my friend to get, you know, because I don't know. She's been a great, great friend. She's my dearest, bestest friend. I've known her since I was like 11, you know. She's like my sister. So over the years, she's always been there for me. She's always, you know, financially been there for me. She's always been above and beyond. So now that I'm working, I feel like with everyone, I feel like it's time that I repay, you know. It's time to pay the dues, even though everyone's like, oh, whatever, but still, you know. So I told my friend, if there's anything she needs, please let me know, like, food-wise, and I would get it for her. So, she actually took me up on that offer, which is great. And we went to, like, this big, it was not like a Costco or a BJ's. I don't know if you guys have BJ's, which is like a its own version of Costco's. They're usually attached to Walmart. And they're like this big food warehouses, you know. But it's a kind of food warehouse, except you don't need a membership. So I took her there, and we were able to get chicken and a bunch of stuff. And they actually sold extra things for the cotton candy machine. Because I don't know if you noticed, you know, cotton candy machines take sugar, like powdered sugar, and then I don't know how the machine works, but out of that sugar apparently it makes the floss of the cotton candy. So the people that she rented the machine from only gave her one flavor, which was like strawberry or something. And so it so happened that at this big food warehouse, they had a cotton candy machine, and they had like everything to do with cotton candy, like different flavorings and stuff. So my friend's like, oh my god, you know, look at this. And she's like, pick a flavor. She was just so excited to see, you know, because not supermarkets don't sell cotton candy flavoring. So I mean, we saw it, we had to get it. So I ended up picking a pina colada candy cotton candy flavor. So I was kind of like excited to see what that tastes like. And so, at the party, I was supposed to run the cotton candy machine, but then, for some reason, we couldn't figure out how to work it at first, and then this other girl came along and figured out how to work it, and so she was working the machine. Unfortunately, I got stuck with Popcorn Lady, and so on my day off, I had to serve customers. There was like a line of people that wanted popcorn. The popcorn machine was pretty cool, except that the thing that you pop the kernels in got really, really heated, and you know, you gotta dump the oil in there, and there was oil all over my hands, and the little kernels would just pop, and then it's really hot, and so the things are popping and coming at me. The popcorn machine was really weird because it was enclosed, but at the bottom, I guess it was supposed to come with a tray or something. I guess they didn't give it to her, and so there's this big opening like this wide. And the popcorn, of course, is at the bottom where the opening is. So as the machine is filling up, everything's overflowing onto me. And it hurts and it burns. And I had to invent my own little tray out of aluminum foil and contain the little kernels in there. So, but yeah, I was the popcorn lady. I had 2 cups of orange sangria. And my baby's goddaddy made, what did he make? Coconut rum with vanilla quick, and it was really, really good. I think I want to buy coconut rum and quick and experiment and try to make it. The party was great. We had a lot of fun. The kids were so hocked up on sugar, and there was like, I had to take home little goodie bags full of nothing but candy and all these things. Oh my god, I'm gonna chain smoke now. I'm sorry. So it was fun overall. Okay, so Sunday I kept all the food down. Now, Sunday, my boyfriend and I watched movies. I popped blue popcorn. It was just popcorn with blue food coloring. It was really good. Your mouth turned blue, and your lips and your tongue. So it looked like you were, like, eating Smurfs. So, as we're eating, right, I'm eating something, and all of a sudden, I feel something crack. And I think I was eating candy. I wasn't eating popcorn. I think I was eating Skittles or something from the kids' goodie bags. And candy is a safe food for me, which is ironic. My boyfriend was telling me that. He's like, wow, you can't eat food, but you sure can eat candy. And I was like, yeah, you know something? I can. Candy doesn't bother me. Like, I can eat that shit all day. And it's bad for me, and it's nothing but sugar and all that. And Lord behold, I can sure keep some candy down. So I was eating candy. I think I was eating Skittles. We were watching Sherlock Holmes or something. So, I'm chewing and I feel something crack. It's like I bite down on something really hard. And I spit it out. And guess what? It's my tooth. My back tooth is cracked in half. I had a headache 10 minutes prior to that happening, and I didn't understand why. Maybe it was because my tooth was gonna crack or something, I don't know, but I was really uncomfortable right before that happened. And but yeah, I lost another tooth. this is straight up bulimia. Bulimia is to blame for this. My teeth are really bad, in bad shape because of the binging purging. So I immediately just felt like shit after. I felt so sad. I'm like, wow. You know, you know about the dangers of the eating disorders and things, but when things start happening to you, it's scary at first, and then, I don't know, it's like, well, I don't know for everyone, but for me, it's scary and things, and then, these things don't deter me, though, they don't stop me, but, thank God it wasn't any of my front teeth or anything visible. It cracked my back tooth on the top, second to last, I don't know what that's called, and, in the inside, so it's not visible when I smile, it's all the way in there, but I felt really sad afterwards. I felt like, wow, you know, God, this thing is ravishing my body, you know. So, Sunday I made a cheesecake. I promised my co-workers cheesecake. So when I went to work on Monday, apparently we all didn't get the memo. Everyone likes to bring food at work. And, not everyone. Sometimes everyone does, sometimes everyone doesn't. So it just so happens that me and this other very lovely girl are kind of spoiling everyone with sweets because we both like to bake. So I decided to make the cheesecake, and I didn't get the memo, none of us did, and everyone brought something sweet. It was like a potluck at work. Everyone was like, holy shit, we had I brought cheesecake, the pharmacist sticking the ass is on vacation, so I didn't get to work with him all of last week, and I didn't work with him Monday, so I brought cheesecake. The new pharmacist brought chocolate cupcakes. The short girl at work brought Krispy Kreme donuts, and then the tall girl that likes to bake like me, brought a big container of pastries plus Cuban coffee, strong espresso. And oh my God, it was so funny. Everyone's like, "Where's the salty stuff? Where's the meat and the nothing but desserts?" So everyone was wired at work. I had nothing but coffee. I kept on the food for the birthday party, and I had popcorn on Saturday and candy. I kept that down. And so Monday, all I had was coffee, and I think I had like a shake, and that's about it. The cheesecake was a hit. There was a lot left over. It's in the refrigerator. Monday was very busy. Oh my God. But it was bearable. We all managed to make it work. It was kind of funny. The new pharmacist is funny, and it's kind of like a more lighter environment when he works. Unfortunately, I go to work today and stick in the asses there. I go to work, and I go inside, and I say hi to him. He doesn't even say hi to me. God, who does that, you know? God. You say hi to someone, I mean, say hi back, even if it's just like, hey, are you wave or something, or like a head nod, you know? Like, nod at me, at least. Acknowledge me. But whatever. God, he's such an asshole. Fucking geriatrics. But whatever. Today was very busy and hectic. Oh my God, I can't tell you how busy it was. I didn't even have time to pee today. I held my pee for all day, and I've been peeing like crazy lately. Remind me to tell you about that. So, yeah, it was really, really busy. I learned a little bit more about dropping off, which is when people come and drop off their prescriptions, and you kind of have to process it and process their insurance, make sure that their insurance covers it. And so I learned a little bit more about that, which was good because it helped me out a lot today. I didn't have to bother other people for things that were just so foreign to me, you know. I worked a lot today. I did the front, the drive-thru. I was on production, which is when you put all the pills in the bottle. And I did everything today. Stick in the ass did not bother me at all today. And he had some of my cheesecake. He didn't say if it was good or not, of course, in typical stick in the ass fashion. But he had a big piece, and he sure ate it. He ate everything off that plate, so it must have been good, I guess, to him. Or he was really hungry. I don't know. So, I think tomorrow I'm going to bring pigs in the blanket for my coworkers. I actually have some. I picked it up at the warehouse. They're not from scratch, I'm sorry. But I picked it up at that big food warehouse. It's like this giant thing of pigs in the blanket. And I work from 9 to 2 tomorrow. So, and I work with a lot of people that I like, and I'm not sure if sticking the ass works tomorrow. I think it does. But whatever, I'm gonna bring the things regardless. Maybe I could win them over. Maybe I could, what is that saying? The way to a man's heart is through his stomach. I don't know, maybe I can feed him enough that he'll love me. So, whatever. Today was really, really busy. Somebody left early. I stayed with Stick in the Ass and the very sweet manager, and I did everything at the last minute. There was like 20 minutes left, and I did so much in 20 minutes, my God. The sweet manager, of course, acknowledges me. He's like, thank you for this, thank you for that, thank you for that. Not Stick in the Ass. But he didn't mess with me today. So I think that's good. I wish... I don't know. I mean, I shouldn't really give a fuck what he thinks, and, you know. But I feel underappreciated sometimes, you know, at work. I feel like I do a lot. I look at my other coworkers, and sure, they know more than me, but they're really complacent with their jobs and things, and they don't do as much as I do. Yeah, I get bitched at a lot and screamed at a lot from customers because I'm doing like four different things at one time while they're doing one thing. But I feel like, you know, like I'm doing a lot, you know. So, but whatever. Maybe that'll pay off later on, you know. Maybe I just don't need a pat on the back. I just need a promotion and raise. So whatever. So I just got out of work a little while ago. Okay, let me tell you about my ex real quick before this video. I don't even know how long it is. Okay, so I lend my ex-husband the $100. Remember, I was telling you he was pestering me about lending him $100 because supposedly he has no money, even though he gets paid every week about $300 to $400. But apparently the man is broke. I lend him the $100, and that same day we get into a huge fight because of my boyfriend, and God, and so then stick in the ass, more like pain in the ass, my ex-husband. I changed my ex-husband's ringtone on my cell phone to the Psycho theme song, so every time he calls, it's like it's so funny every time he calls because he's psychotic. He's a psycho bipolar person, I think. He's either happy or sad. The same day we fought, that he said he was not going to pay me back, and then he calls me later on and tells me he's going to pay me. So I don't really know if he's going to pay me or not. But whatever, I lent him the money. I don't know if I mentioned this a few months back. My ex-husband had a problem with child support. Apparently, they had deducted $300 from his wages, and they were holding it as back pay. He doesn't owe me back pay because he's always been in my daughter's life. He's not an absentee father. And so, even when we weren't together, you know, he was paying for a lot of things with me and my kid. So he's basically taking care of me and my kid. And so he didn't owe me anything in back pay. Child support made him pay $150 in back pay, which he did originally when we first started with all this child support business. So apparently now they were withholding $300 or something, and but he could dispute it. So he was trying to dispute it, and it was a lot of paperwork that he had to fill out, and my ex-husband doesn't like to fill out things, and I mean, he always wants me to do stuff for him. So supposedly, for me helping him so much, he was going to give me half of the $300, which is $150. So he just kept on and on trying to fight this thing. The same day, coincidentally, that I lent him the $100, he showed me the letter from child support telling him that they were going to throw out the case, that they were just going to, there was nothing he can do, he's not getting the money back, it's just going to be back pay. So he got mad and he just balled up the paper and just like, oh, well, forget about it, I'm not going to try to get the money back, it's just money lost. And so then came the fight, and he said he was not going to pay me, and etc. So Sunday, I'm checking my bank account, I don't know why. And all of a sudden, I look, and there's $300 extra in my bank account. When I look and I check further, it is from child support. Apparently, these garnished wages from him got awarded to me on Sunday. So this is it. He borrowed $100 from me. He said he was not going to pay me. And now God has blessed me enough that now I have $300 from him. So look at that. I was so happy. I called my sister. I told her. My sister was so happy. My sister jokingly told me, oh, send me $50. And I said, so I was like, you know something? Yeah, I'm going to send, like, give me all your bank account my information, and I'm going to wire you $50 into your account. And she got so happy. I'm going to see her next month before Thanksgiving and try to spend a couple days with her. So yeah, she got really, really happy. I'm glad that I was able to give back. My sister's another person that has always taken care of me and has always given me things. And so I feel really happy to give back. I can't wait till next month. We're actually gonna go Black Friday shopping, and I'm gonna spoil her. She don't tell nobody. I'm gonna get her some like a camera, and I don't know what else, but yeah. So I'm pretty excited about that. God, what else can I tell you? I don't know. I'm okay, guys. I have been peeing a lot. I don't know why. I thought maybe I was pregnant, so I bought 2 pregnancy tests today, and they came back negative. I'm hoping that they're accurate. And I don't know why I'm peeing a lot. I have a lot of cysts in my ovaries, and they're benign for the most part, but I have ovarian cancer in my family. My mother had that, and my sister doesn't have it, but I, you know, things sometimes skip a generation. So, I don't know. I'm not pregnant, supposedly. I am really naive. I don't know much about anatomy, and I'm a, you know, hypochondriac. So the things start kicking in, and the gears start moving, and I start thinking the worst, you know. And it doesn't help that I have the internet and Google and Wikipedia and all these things telling me. The minute I type in a symptom, they tell me I have cancer, or they tell me like all these bad things, you know. So I don't know. My question is this, and please forgive my stupidity and ignorance. Where is our bladder located? is our bladder like? Bear with me, please. And once again, you know, cover your ears if you don't want to listen to stupidity. But okay, is the bladder behind or near the vicinity of my ovaries? Like, maybe the pain I get in my ovaries is, this is what I'm thinking, this is what the madness is ensuing. What if I have a cyst that's, like, getting really big or something, and it's pressing against my bladder, thus making me pee all the time? You know? I don't think it's a UTI, because I don't have, like, the other symptoms, you know? Like, it's not painful when I pee or anything like that. But I have, like, very painful, like, pelvic region in my ovaries are, so I don't know. God, this is why the internet is bad. I don't know what it is. These clinics I look at don't take my insurance. I don't know what clinic can, so I have to try to find some clinic that's gonna, I don't know, you know. God, I'm trying to figure out what else I can tell you guys. I don't know. I haven't lost any more weight. I've gained a little bit of weight, but I don't know if that's because I haven't gone to the bathroom and I'm bloated. I haven't binge and purged yet. I'm gonna be off soon, and sometimes at least the binge and purging. I don't know. I'm gonna try my best to not do that, especially now that my tooth has fallen out. But I don't know. Like I said, sometimes things happen and it just don't deter me, so. I think that's it. I'm gonna go. I hope y'all are well. I'm gonna try to blog tomorrow. I get off really early, and if I'm not too tired, I'll write something. It won't be the best thing, but you know. And I hope you're all okay, and we'll talk again tomorrow. So, good night.